Hi, my name is Felix, and today I will show you how to read and write hundreds of Excel files using the R programming language. So first, we will begin by creating a very simple loop that writes a couple of Excel files into a folder. And then from this folder, we will read all the Excel files that are in it using another loop. And I will show you guys how easy it is to also add some R code inside the loop to clean and validate the data that is inside your Excel files. And at the end of this video, I will show you also how easy it is to merge all the data from the different Excel files that you have into a single consolidated dataset. If you want to follow along with this tutorial, you can join my newsletters on felixanalytic.com, where you can download all the code. That being said, let's get started. To begin, I just want to quickly show you how to read and write a single unique Excel file using R. So first, we will install the R packages read Excel and write Excel, as well as the tidyverse for general data transformations. And as an example dataset, we will use a Texas housing data available when you load the tidyverse R package. And this dataset contains data about sales by city and date in Texas, US. So let's create a folder when we will save our Excel file. And to save this dataset that we have here in R as an Excel file in your folder, you can just run write xlsx. And to read it into R, you can just run read underscore Excel with the path of your Excel files. And if you want to delete our Excel files, which we will do, we can use the unlink function. Now we will see how to write multiple Excel files in R. So every time we have a repetitive task in R, we want to make a function. So here I have created a function that takes our dataset, so Texas housing, filter it by a given city name, and save this filtered dataset as an Excel file. So for example, if our city name is Abilene, if I pronounce it correctly, our dataset will contain only information about this specific city. And only then our function will save this filtered dataset as an Excel file with the city name as the Excel file name in our folder. So let's test our function on the first city of our dataset. And it looks like it's working. Now we want to iterate. And to do so, we will use the map function from the R package per, and we will iterate this function on every city that we have in our list city names object that we created with the unique function. And we see the loop writing the Excel files. Isn't that beautiful? Anyway, as you can see, we have indeed successfully written 46 Excel files in our folder. Let's see how to read and join multiple Excel files using R. So first, we will create a list of all the Excel files we want to read into R. So for that, we will use the list.files function. But don't forget to add the full.names equal true function to get the full path of the files. Otherwise, it will not work. You will not know why. So be sure to add this full.names argument equal true. And as we want to iterate over multiple files, once again, we want to create a function on which we want to loop. So inside this function, you can add different tests as well as data cleaning. But to make things as simple and as minimal as possible, just for this tutorial, I just added a simple test to check if the file path isn't a missing value. Then, as you can see, the function reads the Excel files into R using the read underscore Excel function. But in most use cases, you will have to write additional data cleaning and additional data validation. Let's test our function on our first Excel files to see if it works. Yes. It works. Now, again, we can loop on all our Excel files using the map function from the per R package. So the first argument should be the list of all your Excel file paths. And the second argument is the name of the function we just created. So now if we run our function on all the paths and save the data in a df list object, and if you want to extract, for example, the first dataset from your list, you can use this code, and don't forget the double brackets over here. Now, if the different datasets of your Excel files have the same data structure, meaning the same columns or variable names, as well as the same data types, you can very easily join them together into a single consolidated dataset using the map_dfr function from the per package. DF stands for data frame and R is joining by row. So let's try this code. And as you can see, we have back our original datasets that contains 8,602 rows with 9 variables. And we want to clean and remove the Texas housing folder. On all the Excel files, you can just run unlink function with recursive as true. So now our working directory is clean. Well, I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, just give me a like or a comment. It's always very appreciated. If you want to get the code, just join my newsletters on felixanalytics.com, and I see you in another video. Bye-bye.